pulled me from the raging sea, and I am safe on this solid ground. The Lord is my salvation.
Glory be to God, the Spirit. afternoon, Watermark. How are you doing? Good, 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 good. My name is Shane, and I am one of many Shanes here, and I'm a little sick, so I'm going to be doing a little harmony today, here and there, working on my harms, my harm parts, and it's just a joy to gather and sing today. Let me read this, Psalm 98, and we just sang a version of this. Sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous things. His right hand and his holy arm have worked salvation for him. The Lord has made known his salvation. And we know that that psalm is sweeter now, knowing how he made his salvation known. And he has made his salvation known through the person of Jesus Christ. And so we gather at 4 o'clock every Saturday to think about that and marvel over that. And maybe you haven't been to church in a long time. Maybe you've never been to church at all. And we just welcome you, first of all, to our family. And we hope that it feels like a family, that you feel loved and welcome. The last thing we want you to do is put on some churchy hat and do something you don't know how to do. But rather just taste and see that the Lord is good. And I hope that you hear that and you know that, not just through song and word, but just through relationships as you make some friends in this room. So why don't you stand and I'm going to pray. And then we'll jump into song together. Father, you are good and worthy to gather and sing about. More worthy to leave this place and live out a life that sings your praise. And so we just come before you, the Lord of hosts, and set our eyes on you, our hearts on you.
Lord of hosts, you're with us in the fire, with us as a shelter, with us in the storm. You will lead us through the fiercest battle. Oh, where else will we?
Lord, you will lead us through
Though the earth gives way, the mountains move into the sea, the nations rage, I know my God is in control. The oceans roar, you are the Lord of all, the one who calms the wind and waves and makes my heart be still. Though the earth gives way, the mountains move into the sea, the nations rage, I know my God is in control.
Oh,
This is the power of Christ in me, from life's first cry to final breath. Jesus commands my destiny. No power of hell, no scheme of man ever block me from his sin. Till he returns or calls me home, here in the power of Christ I stand.
Shane. Two Shanes are always better than one, in case you're ever in that predicament. In the year that King Uzziah died, everybody has probably heard this if you have been around here for a while, Isaiah chapter 6. In the year that King Uzziah died, I saw the Lord sitting on a throne, high and lifted up, and the train of his robe filled the temple. Above him stood the seraphim. Each had six wings. With two he covered his face, with two he covered his feet, and with two he flew. And one called to another and said, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts. The whole earth is full of his glory." And the foundations of the threshold shook at the voice of him who called, and the house was filled with smoke. And I said, "Woe is me, for I am lost, for I am a man of unclean lips, and I dwell in the midst of a people of unclean lips. For my eyes have seen the King, the Lord of hosts." And that to me has always been like, I can feel like that's an important scripture, but it's been a little Lord of the Rings feeling to me, and hard, kind of ethereal and hard to get my mind around, until I read John chapter 12, verse 41, that told me that when Isaiah was singing the glory of that King, he was seeing the glory of Jesus. He was seeing Jesus, the Lord of hosts. And that changed it for me. It wrapped flesh in it. 722 years before Jesus came to the earth, this was a vision of Jesus, King Jesus. Psalm 46 is about King Jesus, the Lord of hosts, the angel of the Lord who came down out of heaven and destroyed a couple hundred thousand men in an evening, maybe in an instant. And I don't think our problem, or my problem, with surrendering fully to him is due mostly to my lack of desire. Man, I want to surrender to him. In these times of worship, I'm just like, "Oh, you take all of me, Lord." I don't think that's the problem. I don't even think it's a lack of know-how. I think we know what to do, and we're going to hear about today what to do. But often I think it's just our vision. Our vision is cloudy. Isaiah was one person, and then he had a vision. He saw something, and then he was the, "Here am I, send me," guy. His vision changed, and his disciples were just like that, right? I mean, often they saw him, but often their vision was cloudy, and occasionally he would flex and show his power, and they would see him. Do you remember that time? Jesus sleeping in the boat. They're scared. We're about to die. They wake him up. Jesus sits up and he says these famous words, "Be still." The waves, the wind, they recognized his voice from the beginning. And you know what those guys didn't do? They didn't go, "Huh? Whoa! Glory! Man! Awesome! Praise God!" That's just not how they responded in those moments where he tore back the veil of their eyes or just flexed. They were terrified. The Bible says they were terrified because they knew that whoever was in the boat was more powerful than the wind and the waves. You're scarier than the wind and the waves. I mean, you're nice. You're a nice guy. but you are scary. You remember that time when he walks up to the Sea of Galilee? Peter and the boys have been out fishing. They're cleaning their nets. Jesus walks up, teaches a little bit, and he says, let's go out again. And they're like, kind of went out all night. Kind of didn't catch anything. Kind of not your expertise. But okay. And you remember the story? You throw the nets. The nets start to break. The boats start to sink. What didn't they do? They didn't go, did anybody have their iPhone? Look, hey, praise God, glory. I mean, that was a big catch. That was a lot of money. This is what happened, because Peter saw that. Like, he did the math rightly. He saw what was going on. He was like, I know messiahs. I know, like, King David kind of messiahs, or the one in the line of King David. They rule kingdoms. They bring peace. They bring justice. They don't make fish. Because either you made fish in the net, or you just told the fish to go in the net. Either way, that's really hard. And you know what he does? This is what he does. He gets down at Jesus' knees and he says, depart from me, O Lord, for I'm a sinner. Does that sound familiar? There's one other cross reference to that. Isaiah chapter 6. Get away from me, Lord. I'm a sinner. I don't know who, I thought I knew who you were, but I don't know who you are. And that's how we are. We're so familiar with him. Just a cute Nazarene carpenter rabbi guy, and he's our mascot. But if we see him correctly, like, this is what the kind of things that happen. I mean, just follow the line of the disciples. They just go, oh, take me, Lord, all of me, anything you want. He wasn't a Jewish rabbi in that moment to Peter. He wasn't just a normal, ordinary guy. He was the Lord of hosts. He was the king of Isaiah 6. He was what Colossians 2 says, the very mystery of God. The fullness of the Godhead dwelt in him bodily, Colossians 2:9. And so, God, as we sing a new song to you, I pray that we would just see Jesus. Jesus, in your mind, perfectly intact, is the memory of eating a piece of bread and the memory of making a star. There is no one like you. There's no one like you. And if by your Spirit you would move us beyond familiarity and we could stand in awe before you and tremble before you and feel the weight of the King of the universe who put on flesh to die for a sinner like me. And maybe which only leaves us to the same place that the seraphim were left of a holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty. And so we sing to you. We join in that song. A lot of us by faith, we just join in. We know it's been going on and it will forever go on. And we sing to you.
Holy, are all God's children singing holy, nothing left to say but holy. Oh Lord, oh my heart, take.
Sing together.
Holy,
all God's children.
All God's children singing holy. Nothing left to say but holy. Oh Lord, oh God, the firstborn over all creation, far beyond imagination, visible and invisible things bow before Christ our King. The Godhead dwelling fully in Him, yet crucified for our salvation. God, Jesus Christ, Lord of all.
My church, we sing to Him.
Hey. Holy, all God's children singing, holy, nothing left to say but holy. Come and join the angels, come and join the song. A melody well known from beginning of creation to the end of kingdom come. Sing now.
Join the song. Hey, Shane Bernard here. Our hope is that you loved that video, that you were blessed by that worship set. And if you want to learn the songs that you just saw and hundreds of songs like that, then come visit us at theworshipinitiative.com. And if you would, subscribe to this YouTube channel where we're sending out constant resources to you. And so do that. Love you guys. Praying for you. Shane Bernard.